fruitful through the abiding word. In John 15, verses 4 and 7, the Lord Jesus said this, "Abide in me, and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me." Verse 7, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you." In John 15, Jesus portrays to us the importance of this having a wild or alive, dynamic relationship with him, spiritual relationship. He says, "You must abide in me, and if I abide in you, then you will be fruitful." And then in that same context, he goes on to say in verse 7, "You abide in me, and my words abide in you." So think about this. We abiding in him is us dwelling in him, continuing in him. And he dwelling in us, he equates it to his words abiding in us. That word abide means to be alive and to reside. To abide means it's alive, it's not dead, it's not dormant, it's alive, it's living. But it is also dwelling, that means it's residing, it's staying, not coming and going, not transient, but permanent. So what Jesus is saying is, he says, "I want my word to dwell in you in a living way, in a dynamic way, in an active way, and to be in a permanent way." That means, you know, it's not one day I'm full of his word and then I go for a week without doing anything with his word. His word has no place in me. And then, you know, after that, suddenly I have to have the word of God in me, and I begin to make space for the word of God in my life. It's not like, you know, on, off kind of thing that he's talking about. To abide means it's alive, but it's also residing, it's dwelling, it's there. It's living and dwelling. And he says, "If my words abide in you," if his word abiding in us is equated to him abiding in us. And when we are abiding in him and his word is abiding in us, the promise he gives us is, he says, "You will be fruitful." Our fruitfulness is connected to this abiding, to us abiding in him and his word abiding in us. He says, "You will be fruitful. You'll be fruitful even in your praying. You can ask whatever you want and it will be done for you." You know, just imagine, he's giving us a blank check. He's saying, "Look, you can ask whatever you desire and it will be done for you." Meaning it's guaranteed, it will happen. But the key is that the precondition to that is this: you abide in me, you dwell in me, and let my word abide in you. Let my word fill your being. Let my word be alive in you. Let my word take permanent residence in you. Let my word dwell in you. And if that's the kind of relationship we have with Jesus, then he's saying, "Look, I have this confidence in you that you, I'm telling you, you can ask whatever you want, because we're not going to ask anything contrary to his word when his word is dwelling in us. We're not going to ask for anything. We're not going to desire for anything that contradicts his word when his word dwells richly in us." So you can ask whatever you will, and he's saying it will be done for you. Wow. That's a wonderful place to be, a place of great fruitfulness in life, a place where every prayer we pray is answered, a place where we can bear much fruit in whatever God has called us to do, that we will be fruitful, we will thrive, we'll be successful, we will be bearing fruit for his kingdom. But it comes when we let his word abide in us. Let his word dwell in you. Let his words be alive in you. It is a key to fruitfulness in our lives. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you that you've unveiled to us this important key to being fruitful, us abiding in you and your word abiding in us. Oh God, we pray that the word of Christ will dwell richly in us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.